Welcome to our Fall 2018 Commencement Ceremony. Leading in the President's Party is Michelle Holloway, the official mace bearer. And now entering are the FGC faculty and staff marshals, Mr. Travis George and Dr. Patricia Love, leading in the faculty and staff of Florida Gateway College. And now, the Fall Class of 2018, led by student marshals Japera Denson and Mrs. Janice Brothers. Thank you. Gentlemen, please remove your hats, and if everyone will please stay standing for our national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the stars early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight? Oh, the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave over the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Good evening. Let's have another round of applause for Hannon Herndon for that wonderful rendition of our national anthem. If you would all please be seated. I'm Suzanne Norris, and I'm the chair of the Board of Trustees here at Florida Gateway College. It's an honor on behalf of the trustees, the president, the faculty, and staff of Florida Gateway College, and the guests on the platform to welcome you to the 2018 Fall Commencement. First, let me introduce to you our platform. Starting from the back row on the right is Mr. Trey Johnson, Student Government Association President, Ms. Heather Paul, Student Speaker, Ms. Michelle Holloway, Vice President, Business Services, and the official Florida Gateway College Mace Bearer, Dr. Brian Dobson, Vice President for Academic Affairs, Ms. Sharon Best, Executive Director of Human Resources. And on the front row, Dr. Jim Surrency, Gilchrist County Board of Trustees, Mr. Chuck Brannon, Baker County Board of Trustees, Dr. Lawrence Barrett, President of Florida Gateway College, Ms. Catherine McGinnis, Dixie County Board of Trustees, and Mr. David Crawford, Baker County Board of Trustees. Our welcome speech today is delivered by Trey Johnson, the Florida Gateway College Student Government Association President. Trey Johnson is a Lake City native and a longtime member of the FGC community. From a very young age, Trey was introduced into our family through several family members who worked at the college. He is pursuing his AA in psychology and will graduate in spring of 2019. Following graduation, Trey plans to attend UCF and earn his degree in psychology. Please welcome Trey Johnson.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It is with great honor that I welcome you all to our graduation ceremony for our esteemed guests, the class of 2018. Graduates, as you cross this stage, you will not only be receiving your degree, you will be turning the page into a new chapter of your life. I'm sure that throughout the past couple years, you've all faced your own trials and tribulations. And here you are today after passing every last one of them. The story of your life shall never end so long as you strive to move forward and improve the world of those around you. And I have every bit of confidence that you will do so in the future. If anyone should ever cast doubt in your ability to follow through, look back to this day and realize they couldn't be more wrong. Thank you.
Good evening, and thank you. And
Welcome to graduates and families and friends. I have the honor to introduce our student speaker tonight. The privilege today of introducing our graduation speaker, Ms. Heather Paul. She is an Army veteran who matriculated at Florida Gateway College in 2016 and is graduating with her Associate in Arts degree. Heather's future plans include applying for and completing the sonography program at Santa Fe College. Please welcome Ms. Heather Paul as our speaker tonight.
Hello, everyone. My name is Heather Paul, a fellow FGC student, and I am honored to be one of the commencement speakers today. I would like to start by welcoming the friends and family to the 2018 fall graduation and by congratulating my fellow students for achieving a dream and at the same time closing a chapter. Tomorrow will be the start of a new journey, and even though some of us know our next step, it doesn't mean that we aren't nervous or unsure about the future. There have been times in my life where I was nervous or unsure, but I overcame that fear, pushed myself, and achieved more than I thought possible. Here's a little bit of my story. In May of 2013, I graduated high school, and in August that same year, I joined the Army. I had no idea what to expect, and honestly, I didn't think I would make it, but I did. In 2015, as a U.S. soldier, I called my mother heartbroken because I was watching people that I graduated high school with graduate college. College was always in my future, but there I was, sitting in the field, dirty, with no college credits to show. And I wasn't sad or heartbroken because they were succeeding. I was sad and heartbroken because I was comparing my success to theirs and I felt behind. In 2016, I was finally out of the Army and able to start college. I chose to start here at Florida Gateway College because they have a smaller class size, and I had faith in the faculty and staff that they would do what they needed to do to ensure the success of all students here, and I was right. Much like basic training, I didn't think I would make it through that first semester, but I did, and I overcame the fear and doubt, and now, here in 2018, with all of you, I'm earning my degree. Because knowledge should be shared, I would like to leave you with two things that I learned the hard way. First, I mentioned before that I compared my success to my peers, but what I have learned is that success cannot be made any more or any less than the people you went to high school with, or the people sitting next to you, or the people you look up to. Success is a personal, it's just personal. A small success or a big success to me could be a big or small success to you, and you can't take that away from anybody. No one can take your success away from you. And two, you only know the battles you face to get here, and no one can take that from you. Second, it's okay to be scared and unsure. I recently read a quote from an unknown author that said, "Fear, it has two meanings. Forget everything and run, or face everything and rise. The choice is yours." Many times I didn't think I would make it through my trials, but each time I decided to rise, and in my opinion, I have come a long way. And as I look out today, I'm sure you have too. Before I get off stage, well, go sit back in my seat, I would like to tell you that I am proud of you. Whether I know you or not, I am proud of you. Now tomorrow, when you face your next chapter, I urge you to remember that you have the power to run or rise, and I pray you choose to rise. Thank you all, and God bless. Good night.
Hard to follow that. Thank you, Heather. Well, welcome parents, grandparents, family, friends, faculty, staff, trustees, especially our graduates for this fall 2018 commencement. My name is Dr. Lawrence Barrett, and as I was visiting with some of the graduates earlier, before, as they were robing, I told them this ceremony would be 3 hours. But I assure you, if anyone knows me, it won't be 3 hours. But I would like to share some of my thoughts with you today. Before I begin, I'd like to acknowledge any veteran graduates we have with us today. Please stand, those graduates, and those graduates are wearing the red, white, and blue cords. So if you could please stand. Please remain standing. I'd also like to recognize any other veterans we have in our audience today. Please stand and be recognized. Thank you all for your service to this country that allows events like this to take place every day in America. We have some students in our audience that are wearing white cords. Those represent the cords of our dual enrollment students, and the gold sashes and the gold tassels represent Phi Theta Kappa students. Tonight's graduating class consists of 575 graduates. 116 are with us tonight. 33% of those graduates are earning an associate in arts degree, 14% are earning an associate's in science, 47% are earning a certificate, and 7% are earning a bachelor's degree. Our youngest graduate tonight is 17, and our oldest graduate is 60. Six of our students at this graduating class are current dual enrollment students. 65% of our graduates come from our five district counties of Dixie, Columbia, Baker, Union, and Gilchrist counties. 9% are from Suwannee County, and 6% are from Alachua. This is our second year of having a fall commencement in December. We decided to have this ceremony, number one, because we simply ran out of room for all the friends and family of our increasing number of graduates. But the real reason was we did not want those that graduated mid-year to have to wait to celebrate to May. So this graduation is very special to all of us and is exemplified by this huge audience tonight. I want to acknowledge the faculty and staff that have inspired, challenged, and educated these graduates this evening. When we say that we are student-centered, we truly are, and I'm thankful for the FGC family that has helped these graduates across the finish line. To those in the audience, we thank you for helping and supporting these graduates. I always state that graduation is a three-legged stool. The students must want to learn and achieve. The college has to teach and facilitate learning, and that family, friends, and others must support that student for success. If we all do what we are supposed to do, then the majority of these students will achieve graduation and success. There are 115 success stories that all of us are proud of tonight. Now for on to my speech. As most of the faculty and staff know, I love the months of November and December because it is much cooler weather and all of the different holidays that we celebrate during this time. Florida Gateway College embraces all cultures and customs during this holiday season. Though not all-inclusive, this month some of our students and graduates are celebrating Kwanzaa, Hanukkah, and Christmas. I want to speak to you graduates this evening about some Christmas traditions and thoughts and then how they relate to you. Here we go. I would encourage you to aspire and mirror some of the leadership qualities of Santa Claus. Let me explain. First, Santa is adaptive and innovative. Through the years, Santa has had to adapt. An example is that people from all over the world wanted to know when Santa would appear in their communities. In 1958, the North American Aerospace Command, which we know as NORAD, partnered with Santa to track him in his travels. To this day, millions of people go on the NORAD site to track when Santa will be near them. In addition, Santa has learned to adapt his communication skills with not traditional letters, but emails, tweets, and social media accounts. So graduates, embrace what you have learned and remember to be successful in anything you do in life, you need to adapt, even when sometimes you do not want to. Be that employee that will look at a problem, challenge, and utilize the innovation to solve it. Remember, change is constant, and that change is occurring faster now in our society than ever before. Number two, Santa makes a list and checks it twice. Santa is always checking details of what is going on with his toy making. When will all the gifts be ready? Will they be ready on time? How will all those presents fit into the sleigh? How will he answer all those letters, emails, and texts he gets? You also need to understand and utilize logistics to precisely be able to deliver all those presents. Santa is the ultimate multitask leader, but because he makes a list and then he checks it twice, he gets so much accomplished. As graduates, you will either transfer on to another college or go on to the workforce. It is imperative to make a list of what you want to accomplish, either professionally or personally. Set some goals for yourself, stay organized, and continue to check that list now just once. Not just once or twice, but to continue to check it and create new lists for yourself. You will be glad you did. Santa practices teamwork. Working with a great team of elves, other helpers, and reindeer, Santa delivers presents to each one of us. We don't know how he does it all in one night, but he knows he could not do it without his team. His team has set the standard and example of how Amazon Prime, FedEx, and UPS were created. Remember in Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer that when all the toys on Misfit Island worked together to get through that awful blizzard, became an awesome team and helped get back to the North Pole. Teamwork and group skills has been named one of the most important soft skills that employees will need in the future. In addition, much of your next chapter in education will have you learning in groups. All of you have an ideal talent and strength that you can bring to a team, but we are not great at everything, and we need to harness everyone's skills to make a successful organization. So take some lessons from Santa and learn to excel in that workshop, and then someday, very soon, you'll have your own workshop. I'm almost done, so. Be on the nice list, not the naughty list. Santa is always watching all of us if we've been nice to others. Helping others, it is also important to understand that Santa is also being scrutinized and watched by so many. His elves and reindeer are constantly watching, listening to see what Santa does in his workshop and at his home. He is genuinely nice and always caring, and society is always watching if he truly demonstrates that he leads by his heart by doing. As graduates, you will have to make decisions to make in your career whether you want to be on the nice list. This means living by your word and what you say you're going to do, and then you do it, and living a life full of joy, giving, and positives. Be the employer and leader that everyone aspires to be. I know that your life will be much more fulfilling if you do that. So graduates, I decided to write a letter to Santa on your behalf this year. It goes like this. Dear Santa, I am president of a college in Florida that has great students and will be graduating about 500 of them in December. As a former Northerner, I am still astonished that since we do not have a fireplace in my house, my son told me that he saw you coming into our house last year through the doggy door. How did you do that? Well, I regress. Santa, this is my list for our graduates. Santa, if you could make sure that all our graduates be adaptive, innovative, make their lists and check them over and over again, have them practice good teamwork, be on the nice list and not the naughty. In the short term, have them rejoice during this holiday season in what they have accomplished. In the long term, have their goals and aspirations achieved throughout their life. And one more thing, my golf putting has been horrible this year. I need a new golf putter. Thanks for all you do, Dr. Barrett. In conclusion, I have one more thought about the holidays. My favorite movie this time of year is Polar Express and the belief in Santa. One of the main premises of the movie is that as long as you hear the bells on Christmas Day, you still believe. In the lyrics of the song, Believe, it says, I will not sing this for you. Dreams are calling like bells in the distance. We were dreamers not so long ago, but one by one, we all had to grow up. When it seems the magic slipped away, we find it again on Christmas Day. Believe in what your heart is saying. Hear the melody that's playing. There's no time to waste. There's so much to celebrate. Believe in what you feel inside and give your dreams the wings to fly. You have everything you need if you just believe. So graduates, as you graduate tonight and move on, the college has placed bells on each of your seats. Whatever the next step in your life and throughout your life, there will be challenges that sometimes you will not believe in yourself and life will be challenging. Utilize these bells when this happens and remember that FGC believes in you tonight as everyone does here. Not just tonight, but forever. Bells are ringing, there's so much to celebrate. Give your dreams the wings to fly if you just believe. Congratulations and have a wonderful life. Now is the time you've all been waiting for. Will the candidates for the Bachelor of Science degree please rise? These candidates have met the requirements for their degree as presented by the Florida College System, the Board of Trustees, and the faculty of Florida Gateway College. As president of Florida Gateway College, I hereby confer upon you the baccalaureate degree of your area of study, including all the privileges, rights, and responsibilities as defined by that degree.
And with a Bachelor of Science, students, please come forward. Paula M. Kinchin, Bachelor of Science, Nursing. Jordan Strickland Melgard, Bachelor of Science, Nursing. Brittany Wagner, Bachelor of Science, Nursing, magna cum laude. Chantella Celeste Williams, Bachelor of Science, Nursing. Paulette Elaine Singh, Bachelor of Science, Nursing. Jessica Virginia Osgood Turner, Bachelor of Science, Early Childhood Education, cum laude. Kenneth David Anderson, Bachelor of Applied Science, Water Resources Management.
Will the candidates for the Associate in Arts, Associate of Science, Diploma, and Certificates please rise? These candidates have met the requirements for their degree, diploma, or certificates as presented by the Florida College System, the Board of Trustees, and the faculty of Florida Gateway College. As president, I hereby confer upon you the degree, diploma, or certificate of your area of study, including all the privileges, rights, and responsibilities as defined by that degree.
And will the graduates please be seated until your row is brought forward? Wilda A. Draughty, Associate in Arts. Leon J. Iris Rico Graham, Associate in Arts. Hannah Nicole Waller, Associate in Arts, summa cum laude. Christopher DeAndre Jordan, Associate in Arts. Crystal Marie Feichter, Associate in Arts. Aaron Lee Clary, Associate in Arts. Stephen Lamarck McCray, Certificate, Practical Nursing. Tiana Keshe Howard, Certificate, Practical Nursing. Ronkiria Marche Crusaw, Certificate, Practical Nursing. Terica Juanita Dukes, Certificate, Practical Nursing. Tranisha Raquel Pertee, Certificate, Practical Nursing. Sonny Jr. Pierre, Certificate, Practical Nursing. Jolanda Willafine Watts, Certificate, Practical Nursing. Latadra Shantae Mason, Certificate, Practical Nursing. Chrissy Lee, Certificate, Phlebotomy. Shelby C. Ennis, Certificate, Phlebotomy. Kelly Ann Goodfellow, Certificate, Phlebotomy. Jordan Elizabeth Knight, Associate in Arts. Brian Paul Calzada, Certificate, Phlebotomy. Lauren Ashley Flint, Certificate, Phlebotomy. Aussie Dwayne Crusaw, Certificate. Kelly Leanne Pierce, Associate in Arts. Joshua Taylor Beatty, Associate in Arts, Computer Information Technology. Bradley Dalton West, Associate in Arts. Natasha Palmer, Associate in Arts. Valentin Eliseo Moreno, Associate in Science, Environmental Science Technology, Certificate, Environmental Science Technician, cum laude. Laciana Marie Davis, Associate in Arts, cum laude. Heather Leanne Paul, Associate in Arts, cum laude. Hannah Faith Harvey, Associate in Arts, cum laude. Michael Sean Fisher Jr., Associate in Arts. Chase Dwayne Taylor, Associate in Science, Environmental Science Technology, cum laude. Molly Ann Jimerson, Associate in Science, Nursing. Samuel George Johnson Jr., Associate in Science, Nursing. Michael Timothy Carson, Associate in Science, Nursing. Lorenzo West Lawrence, Associate in Science, Nursing. Mike Lee Hubbard, Associate in Science, Nursing. Nathan Wayne Griffiths, Associate in Science, Nursing. Brittany Carol Sanford, Associate in Science, Nursing. Gregory Allen Sanford, Associate in Science, Nursing, cum laude. Carrie Lambert, Associate in Science, Early Childhood Education, Certificate, Child Development, Early Intervention, Specialization. Kobe Ann Ladig, Certificate, Advanced Welding Technology. Blake Ryan Taylor, Certificate, Advanced Welding Technology. Kyron J. Webb, Certificate, Welding Technology. Jacqueline Torres, Certificate, Environmental Science Technician. Kendra Michelle Stevenson, Associate in Arts. Shonda Cristania Lawrence, Associate in Arts. Ariana Victoria Albers, Associate in Arts, summa cum laude. Cameron Lane Nichols, Associate in Arts, cum laude. Austin Tyler Ordos, Associate in Arts, summa cum laude. Shanoa Lee Merch, Associate in Arts, summa cum laude. Lindsay Amber Witt, Associate in Arts, summa cum laude. Kinsey April Witt, Associate in Arts, summa cum laude. Philip Evan Brown, Associate in Arts, summa cum laude. Austin Keith Morris, Associate in Arts, summa cum laude. Travis Kelvin Ford, Associate in Science, Graphic Design Technology, summa cum laude. Brianna L. Rusin, Associate in Arts, magna cum laude. Alexa Ray Park, Associate in Arts, magna cum laude. Kelsey Morgan Parlato, Associate in Arts, summa cum laude. Heather Ezel, Associate in Arts, cum laude. Heather Hamilton, Associate in Arts, magna cum laude. Keisha Gay Shakira Walker, Associate in Arts, magna cum laude. Brooklyn Kelly, Associate in Arts. Angelise Perez Serrano, Associate in Arts, magna cum laude. Arshayla Fane Bryant, Associate in Arts, cum laude. Angie Dominguez, Associate in Arts, magna cum laude. Bailey Patrice Hall, Associate in Arts, Associate in Science, Supply Chain Management, cum laude. Amy Lynn Fredosio, Associate in Arts, cum laude. Laura Gretchen Dykes, Associate in Arts, magna cum laude. Savannah Barr, Associate in Arts. Terry Walker, Associate in Arts. Rochelle Lynn Garcia, Associate in Arts. Kendall Louise Loveday, Associate in Arts. Savannah N. Loveday, Associate in Arts. Logan Heath Taylor, Associate in Arts. Nicholas James Anschultz, Associate in Arts. Blake Mason Tedder, Associate in Arts, magna cum laude. James Farron Wood II, Associate in Arts. Kyle Casey Hunt, Associate in Science, Business Administration. Suzanne M. Green, Associate in Arts. Amanda Lynn Morales, Associate in Arts, magna cum laude. Taylor Nicole Barnes, Associate in Science, Early Childhood Education, Certificate Pre-Hood Specialization. Patricia Ann Howell, Certificate Graphic Design Production. Jacob Sidney Strickland, Associate in Arts. Montana Brooke Jenkins, Certificate Cosmetology. Robert Donnell Forrest, Certificate Cosmetology. Mallory August Nail, Certificate Cosmetology. Lillian Abigail Moore, Associate in Arts, Certificate Cosmetology. Megan Brianna Duggar, Certificate Cosmetology. Megan Lynn Rollerson, Certificate Cosmetology. Caitlin Patricia Wilkerson, Certificate Cosmetology. Donna Marie Watts, Certificate Cosmetology. Jennifer Lee Loy, Certificate Cosmetology. Alexandra Kaylee Falstich, Certificate Cosmetology. Monica Lucas, Certificate Cosmetology. Bryn McKenzie Watts Deese, Certificate Cosmetology. Taylor Marie Bloxham, Certificate Cosmetology. Julie Ann Perryman, Certificate Cosmetology. Lindsay Diana Ball, Certificate Cosmetology. Amy Marie Marks, Certificate Cosmetology. Rebecca Eldridge, Associate in Arts. Elizabeth L. Ambrose, Associate in Arts, magna cum laude. Emmanuel Jacob Jerome Timmons, Associate in Arts, magna cum laude.
Graduates, will you please stand? Time you've all been waiting for, time is tradition. Time is now to move your tassels from your right-hand side to your left-hand side. Ladies and gentlemen, the fall graduating class of 2018. As we end tonight's ceremony, I'd like to ask that the audience remain standing and wait till all the graduates and faculty have exited. The graduates will exit to the song, Have It All by Jason Mraz. Their names will scrawl on the screen above the door as they go by. Thank you very much for attending tonight's graduation. And once again, graduates, congratulations.
May you have auspiciousness and causes of success. May you have the confidence to always do your best. May you take no effort in your being generous. Sharing what you can, nothing more, nothing less. May you know the meaning of the word happiness. May you always lead from the...